Hello friends, myself Dr. Hiren Amin. Welcome to my channel Text and Knowledge Hub. Friends, today we will learn about two points, passage of material in shuttle loom and loom drive, arrangement of loom shafts. Let's start our first point, passage of material in shuttle loom. For any passage, objective, supply material, delivered material and elements are very important. Here, objective is to form woven fabric. In the loom, there are two types of supply materials, warp and weft. Warp is length oriented yarn and weft is width oriented yarn. Warp is supplied from the backside of loom, from the weaver's beam in form of warp sheet. Weft is supplied from the side of loom. Pun fixed into shuttle supplies the weft yarn. Here, delivered material is two-dimensional woven fabric. For the shuttle loom, important elements are listed here. Weaver's beam, backrest, lees rods, hilts, reed, shuttle, race board, temple, front rest, tension rod, emery roller and fabric roller. It is the schematic presentation of passage of material in shuttle loom. Here, weaver's beam supply the warp yarns and shuttle supply the weft yarn from pun. Let's understand passage of material in shuttle loom in detail. Warps in the form of warp sheet unwound from the weaver's beam and pass over the backrest connected by a bracket at each end. Now, warp sheet is divided into two sets. First set of warp ends pass under the back lees rod and second set of warp ends pass over this back lees rod. Those warp ends which pass under the back lees rod now pass over the front lees rod, and warp ends which pass over the back lees rod now pass under the front lees rod. The lees rods assist in forming an even shade. Leaving the lees rods, warp ends next pass through the hilts. The hilts consist of hilt wires with eyes at the center through which the warp ends are passed. The warp ends have upward and downward movement through the hilts. The warp ends next pass through the reed, this being comprised of a flat wire comb with the teeth secured at both ends. At the line point where the fabric is formed, that is known as the fabric peak point. It is considered as the point where the warp and weft become fabric because it is the point where the last peak of weft, which was left by the shuttle and was beaten up by the reed. Passing forward, the fabric is held on each side by a temple. Temple holds the fabric salvage area and try to maintain fabric width equivalent to warp yarn reed width. From the temples, the fabric passes over the front rest, partly rounds the emery roller and tension rod, and then finally wound onto the fabric roller. Now we start our another point, loom drive. In the loom shade, drive can be of two types, individual drive and group drive. In individual drive, each power loom is driven by an individual motor. In group drive, group of looms is driven by means of a common motor. In light fabrics, low rating motors, and for heavy fabrics, high rating motors are employed. Loom motors must withstand the effects of humidity. Cotton fluff should not get collected on the motor surface to avoid burning of the same due to motor heating. The cooling fan helps to avoid the collection of cotton fluff on the surface. Here we have line diagram of loom drive for basic shuttle loom. A loom drive mechanism comprising a main electric motor having high starting torque as well as compact body. Basic motors are either foot mounting type or flat base mounting type. In shuttle loom, the main motor gives drive first to the crankshaft through motor pulley and loom pulley. After that, from the crankshaft, drive is transferred to the bottom shaft. And finally, from the bottom shaft, drive is transferred to the tappet shaft. In most cases, ratio of number of teeth on crankshaft gear wheel to the number of teeth on bottom shaft gear wheel is 1:2. In this way, speed of bottom shaft is equal to speed of crankshaft divided by 2. Speed of crankshaft and bottom shaft can be found in following ways. Speed of crankshaft is equal to motor speed multiplied by diameter of motor pulley whole divided by diameter of loom pulley. Speed of bottom shaft is equal to crankshaft speed multiplied by number of teeth on crankshaft gear wheel whole divided by number of teeth on bottom shaft gear wheel. From this discussion, it is clear that two shafts are very important in loom drive, crankshaft and bottom shaft. Drive transfer from motor to the first motor pulley. From the motor pulley, it is transferred to the loom pulley. And from the loom pulley to the crankshaft and crankshaft to the bottom shaft. With the help of bottom shaft, shading and picking operations are performed. And from the crankshaft, beat up operation is performed. When crankshaft makes one revolution, one pick is inserted. If it has a speed of 70 rpm, 70 picks will be inserted in a minute. Crankshaft speed in rpm also indicates the picks per minute ppm. 70 rpm is equal to 70 ppm and that is called as pick insertion rate. Friends, in modern high-speed machines, main drive is provided through super-fast startup motor. Independent servo motors can also control shading motion, let-off and take-up mechanisms. In the next learning module W5, we will learn about important loom elements like reed, held, shuttle, etc. If you like it, you can subscribe this channel for new updates. You can also post your comments for any query or suggestion if you have. You can also share technical details to enrich this module. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye.